Well, good morning, church family. It is Wednesday, April the 29th, and I hope today that you are doing well. We miss you. I can't wait to see you again. I believe it's going to happen, maybe, hopefully, sometime in the middle of May. And so it'll be great as we get to meet together and worship our Lord together again. It may look a little bit different, but I hope that, please know that I hope that'll be happening soon. So today's verse. Actually, I'm going to read a few verses today. It comes out of Matthew chapter 6, 25 through 34. And I'm really not going to talk a lot about it, but I just want the verses to speak for themselves, because the truth is that today God just takes care of us. God will give us our needs. He supplies our needs. May not supply our wants, but He supplies our needs, what we need. Every day, and He supplies our needs going through each day, and during these seasons in our life that are really hard, He supplies our needs, and He will be there guiding and giving you what we need, giving you what you need, giving me what I need during these times. So I'm just going to read these verses, and I pray that the power of the spoken word, God's holy word, will just resonate in your soul. So let's read these. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life. That's the phrase, do not be anxious about your life. What you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more important than food, and the body more important than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more valuable than they? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to his lifespan? And why are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. I tell you, even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is alive and tomorrow is thrown in the oven, will He not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, what shall we wear? For the Gentiles seek after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows what you need. Your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. And I just want you to be encouraged today that to seek first the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness, and all of these things, all the things that you need, will be added unto you. I believe that Jesus is speaking here in the Sermon on the Mount, and I believe these words resonate in our life today. Seek after His kingdom. Seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. I'm praying for you today. I hope you have a great day. So let's pray. Jesus, my prayer to God is today that no matter where we are today, Lord, that as the Bible says, as you tell us in your scripture, that we are not anxious. That's a hard place to be, because it seems like we, at least myself, God, I always get anxious, get worked up, worried, concerned, whatever you want to call it, or afraid. God, but the truth is, the Bible says that we are supposed to seek after you. We're supposed to seek first the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness, and all the things that we will need, all these things that was listed above, all the things that we need for our lives will be taken care of us. I believe that. I believe God does that for us. Lord, so I'm praying for today that maybe there's people out here that are anxious, they're worried, they're scared. God, my prayer is that you would give them their peace. Give them your peace, Lord. God, that your peace would shower upon us today, Lord, as we seek after you. God, that people that are hurting, God, would seek after you. And the only way that they know how, Lord, on their knees crawling to you, as people are broken And my prayer is that today you give us your peace. Lord, we love you. We honor you. I love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Church family, I love you. Can't wait to see you again. I'm praying for you, lifting you up, and remember to get into the truth of God's Word. And in Jesus, there is always hope. God bless. Have a great day.